Yo, what's good, Jets Nation? This is Jets Media, and in this video, I just want to bring you guys my thoughts on the new look the Jets secondary following the Jamal Adams trade. As you guys know, Jamal Adams is now a Seattle Seahawk, and now we have Bradley McDougald, as well as two first-round picks and a third-round pick. So in this video, I'll be breaking down each player on this Jets secondary, all the cornerbacks and all the safeties, and give you guys my thought on each of them and how I think Greg Williams will utilize this group, because Jamal Adams was a huge part of the game plan last year for Greg Williams, so I'm going to break down how I think Greg Williams will utilize these safeties. And we know Jamal Adams was a huge part of the game plan going into every single Sunday last year. So Greg Williams is going to have to adjust. And Greg Williams is the perfect defensive coordinator to be able to adjust into different schemes. He's a player's first coach. So I'm really excited to bring you guys this video. So with that being said, let's jump right into it. So we're going to start off with the cornerback position. So the cornerback position, there's a lot of names that's going to be in training camp. This is before the cuts. So I'm assuming there are going to be a little more cuts, because they have to have 10 less players going into camp because of the whole COVID situation. So this is the 9 players that I have written down and my rankings of them. So we got Pierre Desir, Bless Austin, Brian Poole in the slot, Quincy Wilson, Bryce Hall, Arthur Maulet, Nate Hairston, and then two undrafted rookies, Lamar Jackson and Javelin Guidry. I really like this cornerback room because it is very deep. You know what I mean? There's a lot of players here. No, there is not one guy that stands out and is the bona fide number one corner of the future. Pierre Desir will be the number one corner this year, but that's kind of like a band-aid in terms of a short-term plan. We still don't have that long-term answer at that cornerback one position. We are hoping guys like Bless Austin and Bryce Hall can develop into that, but it's still question mark. So there's no number one guy that we're looking at is like, okay, this is our guy for the future. Brian Poole is going to solidify that slot corner position tremendously. As all Jets fans know, we are big Brian Poole's fans. He played really good for the Jets last year. Big upgrade from Buster Screen. We had Buster Screen whenever we had Todd Bowles. He was our slot corner. So to move on from him and to plug in Brian Poole, I'm so happy Joe Douglas was able to re-sign him and get him onto another cheap deal. I wish it was not a one-year deal because now he's a free agent next year, because I think Brian Poole can solidify that corner slot corner position for a couple years. But hopefully he performs at a high level and Joe Douglas is able to retain him. I think Bless Austin is going to be that number two corner position. I think he's a lot to prove. This is going to be his first season starting from week one, hopefully to week 16, because last year he came in halfway through the season because he was battling injuries and he was also a rookie last year. So this is going to be his second season into Greg Williams' scheme, and I'm really excited to see Bless Austin. I think he has what it takes to really take that next step. He has the length, he has the size, he has the mindset, he has the scrappiness, he has the toughness. So I really like Bless Austin. I really think that he has potential to take a big step. And as you guys can see, there's a lot of players here I can talk about. Quincy Wilson, we traded a 6th-round pick for him. He came from the Indianapolis Colts. He's familiar with guys like Pierre Desir and Nate Hairston. That's a guy that is a proven guy. Instead of Joe Douglas drafting somebody in the 6th round who you got to take a swing on a 6th round pick, you never know what you're getting. He decided to flip it for a former 2nd round pick out of Florida who actually played with Marcus Maye, so they have chemistry. And you know what you're getting out of Quincy Wilson. He's a man-to-man type of guy. He played well early on in his career. Then he kind of had injury concerns, and a lot of Colts fans were happy they got rid of him because he didn't play at a high level. But knowing Greg Williams, getting a guy with potential like Quincy Wilson, that's a former 2nd round pick, he can get a lot of talent out of like these guys. What I'm trying to say is Greg Williams knows how to maximize players' potential by really expanding on what they're great at. And that makes him really comfortable, makes him really confident. So I'm excited for Greg Williams to get his hands on these cornerback room. Bryce Hall, he is our rookie corner in this year's draft, 5th round pick out of Virginia. Very interesting prospect. He was going in the 2nd, 3rd round, in my opinion, if it wasn't for injury concerns and if he was able to go through the combine and all the skill position stuff. But I really think Bryce Hall has what it takes to develop under guys like Pierre Desir, even Bless Austin, Quincy. There's a lot of people that he can learn from. And I think Bryce Hall could be the future cornerback 1 or 2 on this team. Maybe not in his rookie year because there's a lot of people ahead of him on the depth chart. And no, this is not the final depth chart. This is just what I'm projecting. So Bryce Hall, definitely I'm excited to see him. Hopefully he gets some playing time because I think that he has a lot of things to prove in his rookie season. Then we got Arthur Maulet. Arthur Maulet came in with Bless Austin last year when Tremaine Johnson and Dow Roberts went down. So it was them two on each side and Brian Poole in the slot. And all of a sudden, our cornerbacks were way better than it was with Tremaine and Dow Roberts. So I like Arthur Maulet, bringing him back on a 1-year deal. Nate Hairston, he played a lot last year. He's just going to be a depth player. Not the best player, but he did have an interception last year, so he wasn't terrible, but he did get beat on a play against the Giants, Darius Slayton. I remember that. And, yeah, he's just going to be a depth player. I don't really expect too much out of him. And then these two undrafted rookies are interesting, and Lamar Jackson, Javelin Guidry. They could be potential cut candidates because we need to shorten this roster into 55. I really like Lamar Jackson. He has the size for CB1 in the future. Hopefully we can keep on the practice squad or hope keep him on even the active roster to develop, because the cornerback position is a huge need for this Jets team, but we have a lot of depth there. So I liked how we have so many names, and Javelin Guidry is a guy that's speedy as hell. Like, he is so fast. He's probably going to be a nickel guy in the future, and he's a guy that can even provide on special teams. So going right into the safety position. So there's a total of six players, I think, that's going to be reporting to camp. And these six players will be Marcus Maye, Bradley McDougald, rookie Ashtyn Davis, undrafted rookie Shyheim Carter, Bennett Jackson, and Matthias Farley. So going right into it from the top down, Marcus Maye, he's the best safety on this team. With Jamal Adams leaving, Marcus Maye has solidified himself as the most experienced on this Jets team. He understands the culture. He knows Greg Williams, and he's going to be leading the safety group. And I'm excited to see Marcus Maye, because Greg Williams is going to expand him into so many different roles that we haven't seen before that Jamal Adams had to do. And I think Marcus Maye has potential to take a huge step this year, especially that he showed that he can stay healthy. He stayed healthy all last year. His first two seasons, it was a really big question mark. Marcus Maye is good on the field, but he can't stay on the field. But luckily, his third season, he proved that he can stay healthy and play at a high level. What Marcus Maye is so good at is he's good at a lot of things. He's versatile as heck. He is a ball hawk. He will hit you hard. He's good in man-to-man, good in deep zone. And I think that he is a guy that's going to take a huge step in this defense. And then the new guy, Bradley McDougald. So this is a guy that's coming in for Jamal Adams, the Jamal Adams replacement. I'm not expecting him to be anything close to Jamal Adams in terms of what Jamal had to do. He was blitzing. He was lining up in the box. He was lining up against the tight ends. He was lining up everywhere. I think Bradley McDougald is going to have a similar role on this Jets team, but not just that to that extreme. He's going to be playing deep safety. He's going to be playing against tight ends. He's going to be blitzing, but not as much as Jamal. Bradley McDougald is elite at man-to-man coverage, so you know he's going to be lined up in that box against the tight ends, even a slot corner. So I think Bradley McDougald is going to solidify. He can come in for a nickel cornerback position as well, so he's really versatile. So I'm excited for him to come in, because we needed a guy that is a veteran guy to replace Jamal Adams. I was a little worried when I heard Jamal's leaving, because Marcus Maye and Ashtyn Davis, just those two kind of worries me. There's no depth, but bringing in McDougald is a huge positive. The safety position on paper is not even a big need after the departure of Jamal Adams. You would think that after we get rid of our best player, we need a new safety, we need new players, but looking at this depth chart, I'm comfortable with this, and I'm really comfortable with Greg Williams to utilize these players to the maximum potential. Then rookie Ashtyn Davis, I think he is going to have a spectacular career with the Jets, in my opinion. Maybe not his rookie year. I think this is going to be an understanding year, a learning under Marcus Maye and Bradley McDougald, learning behind Greg Williams and understanding the defense, understanding the NFL, catching up to the speed. But I'm pretty sure in Jamal Adams' press conference with Seattle, he said that Ashtyn Davis has been calling him. He's been picking Jamal's brain, and Jamal sees a lot in Ashtyn Davis, and he thinks that he has a really bright future ahead of him. I think Ashtyn Davis's potential is through the roof. He can be our future free safety, even strong safety, and even nickel corner. I mean, he's so versatile, and he's just a Swiss Army knife type of player. Greg Williams is going to utilize him so creatively, especially this year, because he's going to be the third man. So he's going to be coming in for these packages, and all of a sudden he's out there, and he's not in. I don't think he's going to be an everyday safety this year, but in the future, I think he has potential to solidify himself as an every down safety. Then I got Shyheim Carter. So he is an undrafted free agent out of Alabama. Again, undrafted free agents, it's really interesting, but just so you guys are aware, Bradley McDougald was an undrafted free agent as well, and look what he is. He's an established veteran who has like 10 career interceptions and was a starter in Seattle and really good. Shyheim Carter, coming from a winning program in Alabama, he has potential to develop behind guys like Marcus Maye and all these people, and I think that Shyheim Carter has a chance to really work his way up the leaderboards, work his way up the depth chart, and really show himself like, okay, I belong in this league. I mean, what I love about him, that he came from a winning culture in Bama. I feel like any guys that comes from the defense coached by Nick Saban, they understand football, they understand winning, and I like this undrafted free agent from Joe Douglas. And then the next two guys, I think these are just going to be veteran backups that just provide depth. I don't really expect them to make the roster. Bennett Jackson and Matthias Farley, these two are just veteran guys. I don't really see too much, so I'm not going to talk too much about them. So this is my breakdown of the safety and cornerback position for the New York Jets, basically the secondary without Jamal Adams. Leave a comment down below what you guys expect for the secondary. Are you confident in it without Jamal Adams? Do you think all these players I just named can really prove a lot of people wrong in 2020? Lockdown wide receivers, get to the quarterback, make plays, pass deflections. Like, what are you guys' expectations for the secondary? I love hearing you guys' opinions down below in the comments. And make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel. Been posting consistent Jets content all throughout the offseason, carrying over into this season. With that being said, I hope you guys have a fantastic Jet day, and let's go Jets. Peace.